us, because there's this story that you've been tracking from day one of journalist Anbaragan, who was arrested after he was accused of threatening and blackmailing State Minister Velumani's aides. Now his friends have released a CCTV footage that seems to clear him, that seems to vindicate his stand. He's been maintaining that he is innocent, and now this CCTV footage possibly proves beyond doubt that he was not involved in any form of blackmail. Now, to give you a sense really of what really happened, Anbaragan had earlier submitted a letter to the CBI alleging that AIADMK Neta SP Velumani and his aides were usurping funds to the tune of 5,000 crores allotted for various central government schemes. Now, a day after Anbaragan sent the letter, he was arrested on charges of threatening and attempting extortion from Neta Velumani's aide Parthiban. Parthiban had actually come out and claimed that Anbaragan had blackmailed him in person. Now, the CCTV footage that Anbaragan's friends have released clearly shows the journalist in his house and at the press club with no Parthiban in sight. Journalists are now demanding that Anbaragan, who was arrested under the Goondas Act, be released. Priyamada, you know, this case has created quite a few ripples here in Tamil Nadu. Journalists are now up in arms, raising their voice really for Anbaragan, saying that he was rather unfairly arrested. Now that the CCTV footage has come out, it raises a lot of questions, doesn't it, on whether really Velumani at the end of the day is being shielded, considering the allegations that were levelled against him by Anbaragan.
Well, this journalist V Anbazhagan had been making series of exposés about various ministers and bureaucrats, and which is quite popular here in Tamil Nadu. But then this particular expose that he was planning to make was about how SP Velumani, the local administration minister, was misusing the funds meant for the central schemes like NABARD and few other schemes. So this scam is up to 5,000 crore. So one of his close aide Parthiban had allegedly given a complaint in the police station saying that Anbaragan had threatened him and there is a threat for his life, and only which the police came and arrested him. However, now Anbu's family members and close friends have released an CCTV footage to show that on the set date, that is 24th of April, when Parthiban claimed that Anbu had physically come to threaten him, was not in Coimbatore, but he was at his house in Chennai here, and his house has been fixed with CCTV footage. So they are now hoping that the new evidence that they are submitting in the court will help in his release soon, because remember, Anbu has now been booked under Goondas Act.
And Priyamada, you know, this drama has pretty much been dragging on for the last few weeks. This CCTV footage has now come out. It's very clear, it's credible evidence really that can be accepted in a court that Anbaragan was not present when the supposed blackmail took place. Has there been any sort of reaction that's come in from the complainant Parthiban or Velumani for that matter?
But so far, the minister has not been reacting to this issue. He has been evading the questions of the media. And also media in Tamil Nadu are yet to decide and come together unitedly to fight for Anbu, who had made this expose. So there are a few differences of opinion within the journalist community here. However, Velumani has also not made any clear statement as to why he made his men do this. Because there is a clear evidence that Anbu was not present on that particular day when the threat happened. This apart, there was another case against him saying he created public disharmony in Tiruvayurkada area. A case was registered, but then there is a CCTV footage again on that same day showing Anbu at press club. So there are more than 25 FIRs against Anbu on various cases. And Anbu and his family members and also a few other journalists only believe this is nothing but foisted case by the minister, who was angry that he had written to the CBI.
You know, interestingly, charges are flying back and forth, and hopefully, of course, we will see some truth emerging on who's right in this particular case. It's been going on, as I pointed out earlier as well, for the last many, many weeks. We will continue getting you the latest updates on that front. For the moment, Priyamada, thanks very much for joining us on this broadcast.